In this video, I am going to explain muscles that can be cause for headache. I want you to know this, I am not going to explain every single muscle for headache. I am just giving you ideas that muscles can be cause for headache. Okay, first muscle is this one. This is trapezius. This is very, very big muscle. It attaches to cervical spines, thoracic spine, scapula, and do not forget, it attaches to occiput. Because this muscle attaches to head, if this muscle gets tight, it can pull head, then that can be cause for headache. Plus, we use smartphone, tablet, computer a lot nowadays, right? Then we tend to bring head forward position. Head forward position even makes trapezius tight. Now, this tightness can create headache even worse, okay? Next one is this one. This is sternocleid mastoid. Let's say SCM. Sternocleid mastoid. It attaches to mastoid process, which is the lateral part of head. However, its fiber kind of extends to backside of head. When this muscle gets tight, that pulls head this way, then that can create tension around here. Trapezius and sternocleid mastoid. These muscles are slightly big muscles of head compared to other muscles. So when big muscles get tight, that can pull bone very strongly, right? So sternocleid mastoid and trapezius. Let's go to next picture. Next muscle is this muscle. This is splenius capitis. Splenius capitis. Actually, there is another splenius muscle, which is splenius cervicis. But personally, I think splenius capitis is more involved for headache because it attaches to head. Splenius cervicis attaches to cervical spines. So, in terms of headache, I think splenius capitis has more effect for headache. Of course, splenius cervicis can create headache, but you know, just my personal opinion, this muscle might create headache more. Splenius capitis is kind of middle layer of back muscle, neck muscle. Imagine, there is trapezius on top of splenius capitis. When you dissect trapezius, now splenius capitis shows up. Anyway, this is middle layer of neck muscle that attaches to back of head. This muscle is also important for headache. Let's move on to next picture. Next one is kind of a group of muscle. These four muscles. These four muscles together, it is called suboccipital muscle. Suboccipital muscle or suboccipital. And you know, it makes sense because it's below occiput. These muscles are very, very deep. They are like the deepest muscles in back of the head. These muscles attaches to occiput C1 and C2. So this is upper cervical muscles. When these muscles get tight, that can inhibit tiny movement of occiput C1 and C2. Why are they so important? Because suboccipital muscles are kind of balance sensor for upper cervical spines and occiput position. Why is position of this plate is important. Okay, it's important to maintain eye levels. You know, to keep eye level horizon, suboccipital muscles need to maintain neck straight horizon. Then why is that related to headache? Because too much usage of neck can tighten up suboccipital muscles. Of course, other issues can create suboccipital tight, like head forward positions. And the whiplash here, maybe car accident and head trauma here, but too much usage of eyes because of smartphone, computer, tablet can create suboccipital muscles tight. As I said in first part, I did not explain every single neck muscle for headache, but today's muscles are kind of my favorite muscles. When I worked on these muscles, people's headache tend to decrease. They tend to get relief from headache. So if you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.